Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the music, welcome to jazz history. Amsterdam has always been very attractive to all kinds of artists, especially for jazz musicians because of its great jazz scene and the fantastic venues of the city. Going back to the 1950s and 1960s, I'd like to present to you five of the greatest American saxophonists visiting or living in the Netherlands. They all kept returning, especially to Amsterdam, to perform and to record. Some of them even stayed, like Ben Webster, Don Byers. They came to Amsterdam and made the Dutch capital their residence. So now we would like to play some of their music for you in combination with a series of beautiful photographs of the Dutch jazz archive and some audio samples too. So I will not give a lecture today, just some short characteristic facts which you might remember, maybe even the day after tomorrow. So our first hero is Ben Webster. Ben was not really a sophisticated man. He was not really sophisticated. He just liked to play, as he stated himself. He could also be a man of extremes, like overwhelming sentimentality, or he could be even frightening aggressiveness. First piece we want to play is a piece by Ray Henderson, and it's called Bye Bye Blackbird. Thank you. Thank you very much. That was Bye Bye Blackbird. Ben Webster, he lived in Amsterdam from 1966 to 1970. His landlady, Mrs. Hartloper, she saw a kind of son in him. She used to care for him like for her own son, so making sandwiches or taking him to artists, the Amsterdam Zoo. he really liked that. And he took on his camera and he made films of everything he saw. That was his hobby. So here's a picture of Ben Webster met with Rob Langerijs and Tete Montulio. I think it was in Harlem, even, of all places. Jazz club, yeah. In IJmuiden in 1969, Webster played at an exhibition for his good friend and painter Steven Quint. And Steven Quint also made some, he created some portraits of Ben Webster. So, like we see here, it's a live concert. And there's a very nice painting of Ben Webster, together with the artist discussing the art, I think. So I think it's time for the next tune. The next one we want to play is from Ray Noble, and it's called The Touch of Your Lips. Thank you. So that was Ben Webster. His CD recorded live at the Harlem City Jazz Club. And also now we are going on to our next saxophone legend. And that is, ladies and gentlemen, Cannonball Adderley. Yeah. Cannonball, he created his own style in the late 50s called soul jazz, bridging the gap between bebop and funk, what they called funk music in those days. I think Cannonball was a big man, and he also was quite a joyous man, as we can see. And he could instantly and permanently charm you once he got to you. So, very, very brilliant man with a great impact. Used to say things on stage. He liked very much to talk to his audience. For example, this: you don't decide to you are hip. It just happens to be. So it's not your decision. Other people think of you and they think you are hip. So you are hip. That's how it goes. Cannonball, he started his career in Florida as a teacher. And all his life, also as a musician, he liked to talk to his audience. And so now I would like to let him announce the tunes himself. So here's Cannonball.
This next tune we're about to play has been responsible in a large measure for a big movement in America now called soul jazz. Now that's really is it's sort of a misnomer, because all jazz is the same if it's really jazz. You know what I mean? If it's really jazz. Of course, there are a lot of people who play music and say, well, I'm playing jazz, but you know. So we think that any music seriously exploited by a jazz musician, for the most part, is jazz, so far as they're concerned, and they're the last word. Thank you.
Sven Schuster on double bass, Sven Schuster. Leo Baumeister, piano, Leo Baumeister. So that was dead there, so as they pronounce it, or that there. I always wondered why the people call him Cannonball Adderley. And it's really true what you think. So here's Cannonball in an Amsterdam snack bar just before the concert. he liked food. He liked to have vast quantities of food. At first actually in school, he had another nickname. He was called the Cannibal. So yeah, it's also not very nice. But later on, I mean, he kept on eating, and I think he enjoyed the food. And now and later on, he became the Cannonball. Yay! As we all know him. So yeah, that's about healthy food. So we have another song of Bobby Timmons, the pianist from Cannonball. And I think Cannonball, because he likes to teach, we let him talk again.
Now it's time to carry on, son. If we can have the lights out, please, for atmosphere. Now we're about to play a new composition by our pianist, Bobby Timmons. This one is a jazz waltz, however it has all sorts of properties. It's simultaneously a shout and a chant, depending upon whether you know anything about the roots of church music and all that kind of stuff, meaning soul church music. I don't mean Bach chorales and so, that's different. You know what I mean? This is soul, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? All right. Now we're gonna play this by Bobby Timmons. It's really called This Here. However, for reasons of soul and description, we have corrupted it to become Dish Here. So that's the name, Dish Here.
So next piece, the last piece before we take a short break. So why should I announce it? We have the man himself. So
thank you very much. This is a little tune, you know, if you could call this one funky, that we do, that's based upon a rhythm that's a common one used dancing, and it has been used for a long time. This one is called a sack of woe. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thanks again, ladies and gentlemen. Leo Baumeister, Sven Schuster, Paul Wiley. We're going to take a short break.